Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I'll be showing you my go-to brunch or dinner recipe, which is high in fiber and in protein, and it's super duper yummy. So without further ado, let's get started.
So to start off, I'm adding 2 tablespoons of flaxseed powder in a bowl. Flax seeds are a great source of omega-3 fats, rich in fiber, and if you want good hair and skin, definitely include it in your diet. Adding in 1/3 cup of water and mixing it to make a paste. Keep it aside for at least 20 minutes until it turns into this slimy paste resembling an egg. Now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of olive oil in a non-stick pan. Once the oil is heated, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic. You can use ginger garlic paste. I have used finely chopped ginger garlic, and I've added 1 chopped chili, green chili. Now adding in 1 finely chopped onion. Now I've used a chopper to chop all my vegetables, which makes the task super easy, and you know, it just makes it very convenient to chop your vegetables, and it actually is a great way to include more vegetables in your diet. So once the onion turns slightly brown in color, add in 1.5 cup of finely chopped bottle guard. You can also grate your bottle guard if you don't have a chopper. So if you are somebody who's looking for weight loss, please add this vegetable in your diet. It's low in calories, fats, and it's also low in carbs. And people who suffer from acidity should definitely include lauki in their diet. Now, 1 finely chopped carrot and 1 finely chopped beetroot I am adding. You can grate these vegetables if you don't have a chopper. So beetroot is also rich in folate, rich in fiber, rich in iron, rich in potassium, rich in vitamin C. So all these vegetables are really good for your health. Now 1/3 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1 teaspoon of salt, and give it a good mix. Now cover your vegetables for 5 minutes and the flame should be on low. Now we want our vegetables to be wilted, not very mushy. So that is why I covered them for only 5 minutes. Now adding in 1 sachet of magic masala. If you don't have magic masala, then increase the quantity of salt. As in, we have added 1 teaspoon of salt, you need to add 2 teaspoons of salt in case you don't have magic masala, because magic masala also has salt in it. Now mixing it well. Adding in sunflower seeds, which is optional. If you don't have them, it's fine. Adding in white sesame seeds, 1 teaspoon, just to increase the nutrition. And they also add some nuttiness to your patties. Now mixing it well, then keeping it aside to cool down. Okay, now in a bowl, I'm adding 2 cups of boiled quinoa, 1 cup of raw quinoa, covered and cooked in 2 cups of water gives you 2 cups of boiled quinoa. Now adding in the vegetables that we just cooked. Now quinoa is a complete source of protein. It has all essential amino acids. It is full of antioxidants, fiber, it's gluten free, it has reasonable amount of iron as well. Adding in 1 cup of boiled corn in it. I love corn in all my patties or tikkis I make. Now adding in some fresh coriander. Now mixing it well. Now adding in the flaxseed paste. We had kept it aside for 20 minutes. Now adding in 3/4 cup of gram flour or besan, and you need enough besan to just bind your patties together. You don't need too much flour in it. You just need to add enough that you are able to bind your patties properly. A bigger bowl for mixing, because clearly everything is not fitting in that small bowl. So I'm transferring it to a bigger bowl. Now the ingredients that I've told you here are for 20-22 patties, so you need to increase or decrease the quantity according to how many patties you want to make. Now I'm adding 1 teaspoon of salt because I felt that there's less salt according to my taste. So you can taste it a little and check if the salt is okay for you. Now taking a tablespoon of the mixture and I'm just making a round ball and flattening it from the center. Now sealing the edges, and you need to keep these aside in a refrigerator for around 20 minutes before you fry them. So now I've just added 1 teaspoon of oil in a non-stick pan and I'm going to pan fry these for 7 to 10 minutes or until they are golden brown on low flame. So don't touch them for at least 7 minutes and then check if they are brown. They have got that brown crust on the outside because they turn out super crispy if you cook them on low flame, and these are just amazing. Like, they taste amazing if you let them cook for some time. They are just like falafels but not deep fried. So it's like, you know, just really an awesome recipe for all vegetarians out there because it's extremely healthy and it's extremely tasty. So I'm just flipping and cooking the other side for 7 to 10 minutes on low flame. And once they get this beautiful brown crust on both the sides, they are done. You can serve them with some green chutney or however you like. You can add them to your salad, you can add them to your sandwiches. I personally like to use them as my main meal with some salad, especially my dinner or my brunch. So yeah, these are extremely filling. Like, I can have only 2-3 and they keep me full for really long, and full as in a good way. Like, you won't, they'll keep your cravings at bay. So this is an example of how you can have it as your main meal. Like, here I'm having it with some salad and white soya bean curry. So this is a very high protein, high fiber brunch. The best part is we've added so many vegetables, which generally people don't like. I mean, especially kids don't like. And you know, we have converted it into a dish wherein you won't get to taste all those vegetables, especially beetroot. Like, I don't like the taste of beetroot, and this is how I actually include it in my diet. So I just love the taste of these patties, and I hope you really like it too. So please try it out and let me know your feedback in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching, and happy cooking. Bye bye.